Well, folks, I just got back from the field after playing with this chrome-plated beauty, and I had a blast. This gun shot fantastic. So what we're looking at here is an Adrenalin Angel LCD done in a rare and beautiful chrome-plated finish. But before I get started, I just wanted to mention I'm actually doing this video in my home instead of my shop because there's more natural light that comes in through the windows, and I'm hoping that that does the finish on this some justice. So anyways, like I said, it's an Adrenalin Angel LCD, so that means you get the adrenalin milling on the solenoid housing, the tapered breech block with the lightning bolts and this flaming skull jewel on top, the ropey twisty milling in front of the feed neck, the milling on the mini rig, and then you also get all of Adrenalin's parts. So Adrenalin high rise, air assist, IntelliFeed, blinky LED light, breech knob, on off that's been moved to the trigger frame area, Adrenalin trigger, stainless steel hammer, dual Adrenalin volumizers, which is cool, with jewels, and I believe that's, oh yeah, and the Adrenalin mill D10. And what's really cool about this gun is it's 100% complete. It's not missing a single part, so definitely a collector's item. I also have a chrome-plated low-rise here, so that's nice in case I ever want to run a rotor or, you know, just not have something as high up in the air. As for the finish on this, so like I said, it's chrome-plated finish, and believe it or not, it's probably more rare than the Thunderstruck finish. So in the past 10 years, I've seen about 6 Thunderstruck Adrenalin Angel LCDs, whereas in the same time frame, I've only seen 1 of these chrome-plated Adrenalin Angel LCDs, and that being this one. So I know that they did some nickel-plated Adrenalin LEDs, and I've seen a handful of those, but as for chrome-plated Adrenalin LCDs, this is the only one. So very rare relative to other finishes. So when I got this gun, it was not in the best shape. It had like this layer of oxidation and scratches, and it was not in the best shape. And I spent not hours, but days restoring this thing. I think I went through a whole tube of chrome polish. I had Q-tips, TV screen cloths, microfibers, like little plastic picks getting in crevices, and this is the culmination of all that restoration. This is as good as I could possibly get it, and I think it looks great. I think I did a pretty good job on it. For being 20 years old, it's in awesome cosmetic shape. I would put it probably in the 80th to 85th percentile regarding cosmetic condition, and that's just relative to other chrome-plated guns that are 20 years old or even newer. So it does have its fair share of flaking, like on the barrel back here, and just, you know, little nicks and whatnot, but that's to be expected kind of from chrome plating. It doesn't hold up as well as anodizing. You have to kind of treat these guns like a car, like a car's paint. So you have to make sure you polish them and then put like a wax or a sealant on them so that water doesn't get in. Water and humidity are a chrome-plated gun's worst nightmares. So if you put this gun in like a sweaty gear bag, or you have it sitting in like a damp, muggy basement, it's gonna peel and flake really fast on you. So you have to keep it in preferably like a case with like those silica packets in it, just to, you know, keep it as dry as possible. And as soon as you're done playing with it for the day, before you even take it home, you should wipe it down and clean off any like grease that may have accumulated, or paint splatter or anything like that. So as for the functional condition, like I said, this gun shoots fantastic. I tore the whole thing apart, replaced all the O-rings with new ones, re-greased it, reassembled it, and then I put 2 new trigger frame screws on it because the old ones were kind of worn out. And then I tuned this gun to the best of my ability. I sweet spotted the regs, and then I adjusted the ram stroke and snap ring to squeeze out as much velocity as possible. So it shoots nice. It's got a really soft shot to it. You'd think that it's shooting like 260, 270, but then when you shoot over the chrono, it's, you know, in the 290. So I'm pretty impressed with it. The board is in really good shape. So the temperature sensor reads probably within a degree of actual. I unlocked all the modes, reset the shot counter, and yeah, that's about it. Oh, I also replaced the clear air assist hose with black. The clear one was just kind of like stained and looked kind of nasty, and I feel like the black parts with the chrome finish look really good. I used to have clear dye stickies on here, but I replaced them back with the WDP black ones. And yeah, I think the black looks really good paired with the chrome. In the videos, you'll see me with a black IntelliFeed Revy and a black tank cover. And I think you'll be convinced that black and chrome are nice together. Well, this gun kind of reminds me of grade school when one of your teachers will wear one of those watches that's super reflective, and on a sunny day you'll see like the beam of light going across the room, and when it catches your eye, you're like blinded. It's kind of what this gun's like. If you want attention, you know, get a chrome-plated gun like this and just walk across the field with it. Everyone will, like, it'll catch everyone's eye. It's so bright, way brighter than, like, a yellow gun or a pink gun. This is very, very loud. It's like someone turned on the floodlights. So, but I like it. It's something different. But, as for the gameplay footage, I wasn't able to get the best gameplay footage showing how reflective the gun is because we were on like a wooded field where there wasn't any direct sunlight. So I'm hoping this video, as well as my 360 video at the very beginning, will kind of show off how reflective it is. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed. Stay tuned for more. Thank you very much. With this thing, so it's like really greased on the other side. It's cold out, shooting fragile paint, so it'll probably chop.